Well, guys, it's 10 o'clock Thursday morning. We was at the hotel just 2 hours ago, got the bullet train, and we're now at Sakai. Just said hello to Nishikawa-san. It's really quiet here because everyone's took the fish now up to the All Japan. So we got the place to ourselves. So we're going to have a cup of tea, chill out, and I can't tell you how excited I am. Really, really excited. So, yeah, let's get on with it. Just quickly pan round to give you an idea of the setting that where Sakai is. But there's, you know, greenhouses and ponds all over the joint. I always lose sense of direction. I'm not entirely sure where I am right now. But right now we're going in here. And I'm going to have to turn the camera off and let it acclimatise because it's really warm in here. It's minus one out here and really warm in here. So this will steam up. But there's the first view, Sakai Fish Farm. Just one of many. Oh, Kentro's still here. So he's not gone to Japan or to Tokyo yet. So anyway, yeah, let's turn this camera off and have some fun. So, before we go in now, just thought for people watching this who won't know you, yeah, bit of background of you, really, how you got into Koi, the barn. Yeah, but okay, start cool. off with you know, your background.
Okay, background, I'm Tony Pittam from Koi Water Barn in Kent in the UK. Grandfather brought some Koi into the UK roughly around 1965. My father then got into Koi in the 70s. He started Koi Water Barn in 1983 and I started with the business in about 94-95 we've been coming to Sakai now for about 15, nearly 20 years. My father actually came here a good 30-35 years ago. We've grown from strength to strength, a very good relationship with Kentro, built up over many years. We've come here today. Very, very lucky to be able to come here when we want. We are agent for the UK for Kentro, and allows me to come in October, November, and basically rifle through all his ponds and try and pick out some of the best fish to send back to the UK and worldwide.
And how has koi buying, being a koi dealer, being a koi hobbyist even, changed over the years since you've been in it?
What are the main big changes? I mean, when I first come 23 years ago, the bubble economy in Japan was still very, very strong, and they didn't need to sell koi to the foreigners. I think 70%, 80% was probably home market, and it was very hard to get into some of these breeders. They wouldn't even serve you, you know. And the fish we were buying wasn't up to their standard. But with the growth of koi in the UK in the 90s and the 2000s, by 2006 we were lucky enough to win the or supply the koi that won the All Japan Koi Show, which was a lifelong ambition of mine, and very, very honoured to be able to achieve that goal, which has been an ambition of mine for many years.
And that was the Yamato fish?
That was Yamato, which turned out to be one of Sakai's best oyagoi, parent koi, over the last after the last few decades. And through that we've managed to bring thousands and thousands of good quality Sakai koi to koi hobbyists all over the world, especially UK and Europe.
Yeah, so some guys who know you watching this, they say, oh, Tony, bit of a jolly boy, goes out of South Africa, we don't see much of him, plays golf, enjoys a good life. Are you now working for a living?
Trying to a little bit. I mean, we come to Japan 3, 4, 5 times a year. We're going to get a lot more active over the next few years in preparing selecting more koi for the UK and European and South African markets. And we come to Japan 3, 4 times a year to select the best fish to send back. Obviously Keith at Koi Water Barn holds the fort while I'm off working in South Africa.
Oh, you've got that in, didn't you?
Working hard in South Africa, constructing and building and doing some things that I've been trying to sort of supplement income. And enjoying our time here. So let's go in and have a look at some of the best koi on the planet.
But to your credit, Tom, we can walk in there now.
Oh, yeah, cool.
To your credit, when you walk into these breeders, they obviously know you from old. Yeah, these boys.
Yeah, I've been coming for 23
years.
Yeah, we've known
the sons have took over.
The fathers, the sons. Obviously, my father was respected out here as an honourable dealer. And that has transposed to my career. And yes, we've got lots of good friends over here, including some of the top buyers throughout history. And yeah, let's go in here, and we will meet some exciting. Of those people at the All Japan show later.
Yeah, we will. Cheers, Tom. So they're coming out of there, and I'm not sure which ones are which. Maybe the good ones in there.
That one, Shiramuji.
Oh, so good ones in there.
Good ones in there.
And the other ones disappear.
Ones that.
Yeah, now we've got it. Cheaper, expensive. Yeah, yeah.
I'm having to talk quite loud because, again, a lot of noise here, crashing of water and everything else. But we've had a quick look at one of the ponds and seen some of our fish in there, boys. So we'll be putting them in a bowl later on. But you know what? Like I've said before here at Sakai, you never know where to put the camera. No sooner do you see one pond, you think, look at them. Then you see another one, look at them. Like a kid in a sweet shop, we're only in one koi house right now, first one we've come into. So yeah, we'll try and capture some of them. Some of them, there's so much turbulence in the water, air and stuff, can't really see the fish that well. So yeah, so just bear with me. But yeah, some impressive animals here.
Yeah, these fish are sort of 75 to 85 cm, and they're everywhere. You know, I can look in that pond, up the end on that pond. Yeah, you know, where do you start? But I think it'd be more interesting just to focus on our fish, and that way we can bowl them, and every now and then catch a fish like that, which is 85 cm all day long. That's Tony with Nishikawa-san, who looks after Keith. So Tony, you might have to speak up a bit, there's so much noise going on, but go on, what's happening?
Basically, Kev, we're going to get you working, mate, and me and you are going to go through this pond here, and go through the fish that I selected in October.
Right,
now,
okay.
just by looking in the pond, we've noticed that there's been incredible development already in 2 months.
And it'll be interesting, Tone, to overlay the pictures of when you bought them.
That'd be good.
You just worried me a little bit. You say working, I'm working here with a camera in my hand. Have I got to be more than that?
No, I'm going to be doing the netting.
Yeah.
You're going to be doing the picking up, putting into the bowl, getting a bit wet, mate. You know, you're using that back. Yeah.
Really?
Well, you're good at picking up fish from bank sides, aren't you, I thought so.
No, I'm not.
Yeah, or would you get someone to do that for you out there, do you? Come on.
We're sure we can't get someone? Not too sure
about this netting, like. You have to bend over, get all wet. But anyway, seriously, I'm looking for Sai, because I'm thinking she can do the netting, I'll just film it.
Never seen by many before, Mr. Kevin Ellis.
Look at him. Ain't that me?
I think if this was a pond of lizards, I think I'd have as much chance as getting there.
Doing this because I'm excited at seeing me fish.
Well, anyway, look, here we go.
Yeah. Where's Sai? Can't she do this?
Yeah, she's buggered off to the office, though.
Is she?
But here are the top Tatiboy ponds outside, right? And these are the some of the ones which we've got here, which we'll see better when we get them out. Kev, can you go a bit quicker, mate?
Do you know what? It's heavy, isn't it? Now, turn that off, Tom. I'm getting up. Not such a happy face now. I'll get her to lie down. I'll just fill both them bowls with water. I kid you not.
That one and that one. This is my shower.
But they don't really feed them in here over winter. But yeah, sumi development very, very, very good.
What do you think, Kev?
Yeah, well pleased with that. Well pleased. Very pretty fish.
Very pretty fish.
Fish for tomorrow, Tone.
Sorry, mate?
Fish for tomorrow.
Fish for tomorrow, project fish. But look how much the sumi's come out already,
yeah.
Eh?
Yeah.
Kev, do you want to pick it up and put it in that bowl next door?
Not really.
Go on, show us your skills.
Oh, the water's coming out of it. No thing in it. So Ryan, this is the one you were looking at.
I think this will be a 2-3 million yen pitch.
Yeah.
So I think this is a... It's got indication of very, very good kiwasashi here.
Yeah. Big body fish.
Big body fish. So yeah, I'm hoping this is going to improve.
But could you tidy that up a bit?
Could tidy this bit up here a bit, definitely. Yeah, this bit here is not a problem.
But as you say, if it was perfect, it'd be 3 times as much money.
Oh, probably 10 times more money. Yeah. This lovely sumi. Look at the quality of the sumi there.
Superb. Excellent fish. Well done, Tom. Yeah, launch it.
Yeah, I'm not too worried about this. Yeah, that'll fill in a bit. Maybe we can have a little go here.
And again, on here, Tom, you know, what you're seeing here is honest fish that haven't been touched for our benefit when we got here. But you take that off easily.
Yeah, that comes off very easily, yeah.
And the first time ever I saw the sun rose in your eyes, and the moon and the stars were the gifts you. And the empty skies and the first time ever I at my command, my love, and the first time ever I lay with you.
It's a great couple of hours, got to say. And as I said to Tony, and he's the first to admit, you know, you're looking at some of them fish, some of them ain't perfect, you know, a bit of secondary Benny here, you know, whatever. But you know what? For the money they are, it's all reflective. When we're looking at some of these fish we've seen, you know, elsewhere and in the other pots here, they're ultra expensive somehow. So that was a cracking couple of hours, eh?
Yeah, excellent. Yeah, I really enjoyed that. It's nice. Just going through your fish like maybe you guys do back at home when you go around on one of your pond visits.
I'm amazed you remembered all them.
Yeah?
Yeah, you've done well.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah. So we're going for some lunch now, yeah?
Yeah, we're going to the office and pick Sire up and go for some lunch. It's
happy
12
days.
O'clock at Sakai, which means dinner time.
Cool. Well, that turned out to be a cracking couple of hours. I couldn't be more pleased with my shower. Not least of all, there's some lovely fish there.
And yeah, we re-photographed them, videoed them and so forth. And the point Tony was making, and it's a fair one and I would agree, you know, for people watching this, you'll see, you know, slight imperfections with some of them fish, but you have to have a reality check. We're looking in another pond there where fish started at 1 million yen upwards, and a sold pond where they was 1 and 2 million yen. We'll work that out for yourself. That's £6,000 to £12,000, whatever. So, you know, these fish, they're more realistic cost, a budget that suits a lot more hobbyists than the £1 to £2 million fish. And that's reflective when you look at, you know, we'll go to All Japan tomorrow and we'll see the most amazing fish. And when you go down to any dealers and think, right, I want them fish, fine. If you've got the cost of a BMW to spend on a koi, most of us, in fact a vast percentage of us, haven't. And that's where you've got to be realistic in your expectations when you're looking at some of these fish. I think it's a point that you know, most dealers make, and it's probably a point worth me making on this video. Tom, how good was that lunch?
One of my favourite, that high class
Kobe beef and stuff.
Amazing. Bibimbap.
Yeah, superb. So now we're bowling up the other fish.
Yeah,
the bigger
now we're
fish.
Looking at some sansai and other nisai. This is Tony's pond, Tony's collection at Sakai. Plus, we're going to look at some much, much bigger stuff and some big karashi koi.
Yeah, happy days. Yeah, so this is, again, Tony, how many big fish houses like this here at Sakai?
I think there's about nine like
this. Yeah, 9 houses.
Yeah,
these
just
are massive.
Just pop yourself in here,
yeah?
Have a little look in there.
Yeah, I've been in here before.
Been in this one, look.
Yeah.
A few fish in here.
This will steam up, but it goes up that way, 50 yards, up that way, 50 yards. So this is one of my sensei kahakus from Tony. And yeah, I couldn't be more pleased with this. It looks superb. It's about 60, I think it was 68 cm, can't remember. Very good. So Tony, I just captured this earlier. You picked this fish, I bought it. It's magnificent. For the money, it's fantastic.
It is fantastic. Yeah. Body shape, size, bloodline. I've got to check the bloodline.
What was it, 68, was it?
I'd have to check. I don't say wrongly, but yeah, beautiful body shape, beautiful pattern. Everything in that koi for you.
Yeah, well chuffed with that. Yeah, well done, Tom.
Thanks, mate.
Yeah.
Just get that bolt.
So this is my second fish. And again, it just, what's this, just a bloom on the head, Tone?
Bit of a bloom on the head. Yeah. Water temperature's very cold in there, even though it's in a greenhouse. I'm probably thinking, what do you think, 12 degrees, 14 degrees?
Yeah, maybe a bit more. Nice, Tone. Yeah.
So we've got a bit of a bloom on the head, but hair quality on this perfect sandan is...
superb.
Very, very good for you.
Yeah, we'll chuck with that as well, Tone.
Imagine this at 85, eh?
Yeah.
85 centimetres.
You guys killed it by 75. Yeah, well done. Yeah, the heat quality on that is superb.
Isn't it, eh? This was a very yellowy hee, and already you can see the transformation while it's in the concrete pond, and that the hee is getting a lot thicker.
Roy, this is your fish, buddy, and it's superb. You'll like this. Yeah, excellent. Mm.
Again, a little bloom on the head. There's a few that have got a little bloom in here, but this isn't a problem at all.
Chip, this is your fish, buddy. Again, another cracking kahaku. You'll be pleased with this, Chip. Yeah. So this was the senki we were discussing.
We were discussing the body, and a lot of people thought this was fat or dumpy,
As I did.
I really don't think in the flesh, Kev, you can see. I think that the red pattern where it's in a line here situates the body. The white is accentuated on the side. But a lovely sumi place, perfect three step. It's gonna be a big coin.
Yeah.
Good body, Nishikawa-san?
Yeah.
Good body.
Would you say Nishikawa-san, Sanford, fish carrying eggs?
Carrying eggs?
Eggs?
No.
Now?
Not actually, maybe a little, but I just felt
a
few.
Bit too early for eggs, you think?
Still not hot.
Is what?
But body good for you?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, lovely sumi face.
In the picture, sumi. It looked very, very big. Oh. Maybe too big, but in the flesh.
Yeah, nice sumi placement, Tom.
My picture again, Kev. No good at taking pictures.
Yeah. And Nishikawa-san, on the head, the bloom, what is this? Is like a carp pox or something?
A white skin?
Yeah, the white on the head, on the he.
Well, sometimes, now, just a cold.
Just a cold, yeah. It's the same on the kahaku, yeah.
Yeah, for YouTube, no, no, no.
YouTube.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
No,
YouTube. Yeah,
famous.
No. Superb, Tom. Yeah, this is a male that's not sold. It's probably going to the Hiroshima Koi Show.
Yeah, the Shinkokai Young Koi Show, All Japan Koi Young Koi Show.
Yeah. Again, lovely sumi placement.
Lovely sumi placement. Lovely deep pea.
Very male-looking fish, isn't it? In terms
of the fins.
Pea and everything else, fins, yeah.
Body's good though.
Took some catching, didn't it?
Didn't it?
Followed
that one around for 10 minutes.
Step, yeah. Crikey. Yeah, great body on it, Tone. Yeah, it's had a knock on the
side there.
Yeah.
But again, bloom on the head.
Yeah. But yeah.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah. Lovely body.
Great body line, isn't it?
So, Kev, you bought this from Pitcher.
Yeah.
What do you think?
Yeah, it looks great. They all do. All the fish tone. Yeah, well pleased with all of them, Tone.
Yeah, beautiful body shape on this one.
Yeah, be a big fish, this. You can see it all day long.
The builder's bum going on there, Kev?
Really, Tom?
Let's pan back to something a little bit more enjoyable.
Yeah, look at that. Yeah.
Happy?
Yeah, well done. Yeah.
Yeah, so this James is a fish you're familiar with. And this is the last of my kahakus. And the smallest, what's this, 58 tone, is it, or something?
Looks 58, 59 without checking, yeah.
And the least expensive, but you know what? For what I paid for that, yeah, well pleased with that. Yeah. Put it on the phone, Tone. Yeah, and you too, Keith, when you're watching this. Yeah, very nice fish. What a frame on that, Tone.
Yeah, lovely sumi placement to come. The frame is exceptional. This is from the Rad Bloodline. Lovely Katasumi to come here.
70 cm, is it?
I think nearly 70, nearly 70, yeah. But lovely Subo Sumi.
Yeah, yeah.
All on the white. And this shoulder area is going to be very, very beautiful.
Yeah, very nice.
Expect this to get well over 85.
Steve, I think this is your fish. I'm not sure. So you can see it's actually a bit deep on the shoulder there.
Yeah.
But
it looks like Sumi's coming here as well. So
yeah, three colours in each third and stuff. Yeah.
Lovely head pattern. Yeah.
Yeah, beautiful head. Yeah.
You can black pearl, which I think is the best one. Lovely kahaki pattern and Subo Sumi. Still tatty boy this one.
You know what, I'm crap at this. Bloody hard work, isn't it?
Go on, Kev. Get it.
I'm worn out.
Go on then, I'll take over.
You take over.
He's only gone and caught one.
I feel like I've got
this
one.
This is the first fish.
Take me.
He's caught.
This fish hasn't sold, but I know someone who'll be interested in this. Beautiful white skin on it, Tone, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's got a couple of, might be missing scales. The side. Yeah, very nice fish. About 58 cm, maybe, I think.
If ever there was an example of a photo, and I appreciate now how Tony's photos can be difficult to get when you've got so much to bloody do on a day, but if ever there was an example of a really nice fish that don't look so good in the photo but looks great in the flesh, this is it. Let me show you this.
white skin and he
that,
is
the
just...
white on that is astonishing, Tom.
Yeah.
Yeah, very good. The Benny looks male, Benny.
Doesn't
Benny.
It? Yeah.
Yeah, Benny.
100% female.
Yeah.
Guaranteed.
Nice big backbone on it as well, Tom.
Yeah.
Look at that backbone. Yeah, very nice. That is a standout fish in terms of being quirky. You know, not your ideal show pattern, but quirky, it's a pretty fish. So, Tony, this is the other pond with the bigger fish in.
That is, yeah. And on top there, you see...
yeah?
This one. Yeah?
Oh, the Kahaku.
Ah.
Well, to the Jenkins family, and I know you're all involved in the hobby, that's a cracking fish. Yeah, you'll be well chuffed with that, I hope. Yeah, very nice. Yeah, and a pleasure to see it as well. Look forward to seeing it in your pond, guys. Yeah, stonking fish. Yeah, so guys, just having a little bit of a break. But yeah, that was real fun. Fun because we owned the fish, a few of our boys. So yeah, it makes it even more fun when you're netting fish that, you know, you're going to see again. And excitement of seeing photos when you buy them, but nothing like seeing them in the flesh. I hope between this camera and the phone, I've captured them and done them justice for you guys and myself. Yeah, so exciting time now. Nishikawa-san's come to give us a hand, and we're going to be netting some of these fish. So yeah, happy days.
I mean, you really appreciate the size of this. This is massive.
Now here we have a 1.6 metre Kevin, and look at the size of this, eh?
1.62.
Now this body is phenomenal.
It's a big fish,
yeah.
Really big fish.
Big, big, big fish. 76 cm, Rose Mary, the Kahaku.
Yeah, Tone, on me, we'll have that all day long. Yeah, that's a serious fish. Yeah, I'm well pleased with that. We'll have that. Yeah.
Say sayonara to Japan. Hello, England.
Yeah, for those looking at that fish, it's 75, 76 cm, massive frame. Not a frame that's going to be getting to 85, 90 cm. It's too stocky, it's not long enough in the front half of the body, but you know what, a lot of presence in the pond for not pro rata, a massive amount of money, suits me. It's, yeah, it's a big fish, and yeah, slight eye deformity, but again, yeah, it really doesn't bother me for what I'm paying for it. It's a seriously big, lots of presence koi for a big pond. And yeah, well pleased with that.
Actually, this was a three-step Sankey before. This, I believe, is 78,
right,
if I remember rightly.
Yeah.
But yeah, this was a three-step Sankey, and the sum is filled in. So it actually looks like a single-step one now. Skin is superb for a big fish.
Yeah, very good. Excellent skin.
Ah.
The bigger bowl. This is a nice fish. That's a big fish, Tom. That is big. So that's got to be, what is that, Tom? 80? 80 cm, yeah. Yeah, amazing shape on that fish, and again, you just don't, this is a massive bowl, just don't realise how big this fish is, it's giant.
Big net.
Catch with the big net.
Oh, 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 oh. So that's good. It's just phenomenal.
Thank you.
That's the kind of koi that you put in your pond and every... Oh, stop.
Yeah, Karashi boys don't look like they get better than that tone.
Can't
How big is this?
This one, 18586.
Yeah, that's a superb Karashi boy. That's probably the best one I've seen.
Ever seen, yeah. Only 5 years old, I think. So
that's a serious fish.
So by the end of this year, should be 90. And good chance to get over a metre, 1.1 metre.
That's massive.
But that body line, quality, head.
Of everything, the reticulation.
Superb.
Everything.
Perfect.
That's a superb Karashi boy. Tony's three Karashi boy here. Good job Nishikawa-san here helped to help us. He's a serious fish. Absolutely first class examples. Don't get better. So 80, 83, 85. Yeah.
Not even five yet.
Yes, this is the last. Is this the last fish we're bowling today, Tony?
This will be the last fish we're bowling.
So this again, a three-step. Kahaki, what's that? 70.
78, I think.
78. Beautiful. Nice kiwa on it, Tony.
Lovely kiwa.
Yeah.
Yeah, good body.
Yeah, look at the kiwa on that. Yeah. Yeah, nice example of a kahaki that. Lovely white skin, nice Benny.
This is 4 year old 75.
It's 4 year old 75. 76, yeah.
So 4 year old, it's a fucking big fish.
It is. It is.
Beauty Sandan, so it's from the Beauty Rose bloodline. So similar to Yamato line. It's on the same line as Yamato.
Approaching 4 o'clock now. What an amazing morning and afternoon that was. Super lunch in between. Don't get better than that as a koi keeper visiting Japan. As I said earlier, the fact that we've got so many fish here, it was great to see. I feel like I'd knew some of the fish. I'd looked at them so much on YouTube and so forth. So to see them in the flesh was just, you know, inspiring. Not least of all the other fish that are here. You could spend a few days here and not see it all. So you know, we concentrated on our fish, so to speak. There's so many more fish here you'd love to just look at. But anyway, we're making our way now to Hiroshima Airport and taking the plane, which I think is a couple of hours, up to Tokyo, staying there the night in good time for the All Japan judging tomorrow, where Tony's judging, and I hope to capture as best I can. But anyway, for now, skirting to the airport, but absolutely inspiring day here at Sakai.
That's our 5:15 flight to Hiroshima. Takes from here in Okayama.
Is it Okayama we're at?
Hiroshima.
Hiroshima, that's it, Hiroshima, not Okayama. So we're an hour in Hiroshima to Tokyo, about an hour and 20 minutes. So I've got to say, this flying is obviously much quicker, and it's cheaper than getting the train.
It is cheaper, yeah. There's various Visit Japan passes that you can purchase prior to arrival. And yeah, we've managed to pay just over £50 for each flight. So this is up to Tokyo, maybe 1 hour, 20 minutes. 50 quid.
Yeah, happy days. 7 o'clock Thursday night, and we're checking into our hotel where we're going to be for the next four nights.
Putting on my best shirt. It's judging day at the All Japan Friday. So we travelled up from Hiroshima last night, had an early dinner, early night. And I've woke up this morning to heavy snow in Tokyo that was forecast. Do you know what? That's my phone. It ain't stopped pinging. I had the good fortune of attending like a press day thing. So Tony and Sakai kindly got me a pass. And really looking forward to it. Not been there on a Friday before to view the judging. I think you have to be careful what you can video, like the balloting and things. They're quite sensitive about, but that's fine. So, it'll be good to see the judging and capture that as best I can. And I think if Sakai wins, I've got more chance of an interview with him, because we had lunch yesterday and he kindly said, yeah, no problem with interview. And then I'm thinking he might not be in the best of moods if he don't win. So, yeah, fingers crossed for Sakai. But you know what? To be fair, there's probably 5-6 fish, including from Momotaro. So, yeah, good luck to all of them. And, having some breakfast now and getting down to the Ryutsu Centre.
View from my hotel window. Super view. You can see the snow now, but they know how to deal with it. Famous last words.
Hello, Kev. Here we are. Snowing outside, as you can see.
Isn't it?
-2. But luckily enough, we've only got one stop to the Ryutsu Centre from Tennozzi Isle.
So, because I've stayed at the Shinagawa Prince before.
Yeah, it's a bit of a jaunt.
Which you wouldn't want to be doing there on a morning like this.
Not at all.
Yeah? So what, we one stop and we're there?
One stop, we're there.
Happy days.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Well, just arrived, and as always, totally inspiring. I had a quick skirt round looking at the Grand Champions. I'm going to video myself twice. One saying it's the Sakai Sankey that I think will win. And then I'm going to video again saying, yep, the Kahaku, that was always my first choice. And then whatever wins, I can just put the right one in, make it look like I know what I'm looking at. In all seriousness, there's some amazing fish here, and what we'll do is we'll wait until they've been moved about after this morning. Once the Grand Champion and the other big fish have been announced, they then get put into their respective vats up near the front, and that's when I'll probably capture them. But right now, just having a wander around while Tony goes to his meeting, ready to start the judging. But superb. Yeah, Sakai Sankey gets my vote. Yeah, superb fish. Yeah, Sakai Kahaku gets my vote. Superb fish. Just in case. Yeah, Momotaro Showa definitely gets my vote. Superb fish.
This is the judges' meeting about 9:30 Friday morning.
I'm in group number 8, which is size 70 for you. So I'll be judging some big, decent fish today. Yeah, I was a little bit scared I'd get the 15 babies, but very happy.
Yeah, good.
70cm. And Odawara and Kondo-san are in my group as well. So should be fun today.
Yeah, nice one. So that introduction lasted about half an hour. The judges are now coming in to start the judging. Let the excitement begin. I think they're now getting ready to vote, having spent the last hour looking at the fish.
rest of the first round, everyone's voted. And now they start narrowing it down. So they look like the adjudicators, I guess.
Yeah, so I'm guessing what happens now, that's the first round that they've all voted. It's unlikely the grand champion will be chosen from that. So they'll do the same again and again and again until it's narrowed down to the GC. So, yeah, no need to film it all, but as it starts to get to the final vote, I'll do my best to capture the moment when everyone goes, ooh.
In truth, I couldn't get to see which two it was. I know there's one Kahaku I saw, don't know which one it was. And then I think this is the second round of judging. So they've narrowed it down to two fish as a result of the ballot first round. Yeah. It's going to the two Kahakus, Daimichi and Sakai.
Yes, for me, having seen both of them, I would say it's the Sakai over the Daimichi.
So this is now the second round of counting between the two showers.
Yeah, so now with this judging system, you know, you'll have your friends of Daimichi, your friends of Sakai. I'm sure that will influence people's decisions, as it probably would me, I guess. But this seems about the fairest way you can do it. Don't know how many judges there are there, but there must be over 100. So, yeah, it's exciting because, you know, for sure now, one of these fish is going to be announced any moment now. And as I say, again, for me, the Sakai fish slightly bigger. We'll have a closer look at him. He's all too busy up there. Everyone jostling for position. But yeah, for me, Sakai fish slightly bigger, slightly better body. But who knows? I guess it might come down to how many friends of Sakai are here and how many friends of Daimichi are here. I really don't know. So I think the grand champion's a Sakai fish, I'm not sure. A bit confused.
The first ballot, because only two koi got more than 10 votes, only two koi went forward to the final ballot. So it was between the Sakai Kahaku and the Daimichi Kahaku. Sakai Kahaku has won.
It has won. I was a bit confused.
It has won, yeah.
Excellent.
I believe that Sakai Kahaku was handled by Narita Koi Farm and Nakamori. And co.
Right.
So congratulations to those.
Yeah.
I was actually standing next door to Mano-san from Toyota, Daimichi, and you could see the disappointment. Well, must have been close.
Yeah, sure.
But both, beautiful koi.
Yeah, so let's have a look.
So let's go and have a look at the grand champion now.
Yeah. So we're now looking at the grand champion, Kohaku from Sakai. Yeah, worthy winner, as every year, Tony.
Yeah,
how would you critique that fish? And what's your thought on the...
I think a very good koi, body shape extremely good, 93 centimetres. And obviously a lot of support behind it. A lot of support behind this koi.
It's got a perspective of size now with that fish in front of the judges. This is the reserve grand champion from Daimichi.
Only two koi, no other koi got more than 10 votes.
Okay.
So only this one and that one got more than 10 votes. Perfect.
Maybe
posing. Hi guys, that's the grand champion vote over with. I'm not going to tell anyone who I voted for. But here we go. This is the booklet that I get to judge. I've got size 70, which is an amazing size. You know, you've got some beautiful fish in here, and this is what you get.
And a lot of fish in that size category.
Yeah, so I think there's 87 fish in this category.
So, you've got to pick...
so for Kahaku, we have this. Yeah.
Yeah. And these are 70 to 75 centimetres.
No, up to 70.
Up to 70.
Yeah.
Right.
Thank you. Showa. Shiro. So let's straight away, let's have a look at this Shiro. Yeah. It's got to be between these two, eh? But let's go and have a look at body shapes.
Yeah,
and,
you weren't judging that on pattern though, first though, was you?
Probably, yeah, but also...
I don't know that you can. I think you have to judge
okay,
on skin, body.
Okay, but if we're looking at... But obviously we've got to look there, but straight away, in my mind, that's probably the best body.
Yeah.
Yeah? This one doesn't look good body. This one doesn't look good body.
Right.
Good body? Not sure about this body. Yeah? So, my one would be go for there. But got to have a look at the fish, you know?
Absolutely,
I know you can do so much from a picture, but... I think I might pick that Goshki though. I think that's going to win. What do you reckon?
Yeah, rest of those quite.
Yeah, exactly. Let's go for that one, eh? Gimme Goshki. I think I'll vote for that one.
Yeah.
Kawaii. Well, that's one Kajaku. That's one.
So how long do you have to do this, Tom? To make a decision?
No, you do it as a team.
Yeah.
So the team leader will say, I think this one. And then you put your hand up and you either vote for it or you don't.
Right, got it, yeah. Right, buddy, I'll leave you to it.
No worries.
Yeah, well done, Tom.
When we get going, come over and
have a look.
See how it's done.
Yeah, that was a real privilege to be here this morning, witnessing all that. I hadn't done it before. So, I'm now going to sort of follow a couple of the judges and just see what they're up to. Won't video it for too long. I don't know if it's that interesting if it goes on forever. But, right now, I'm probably going to go and have a cup of tea and chill a bit. Come back, have a look at the fish, and I'll probably capture the fish more tomorrow on video, go around systematically. And when you're doing that video, you don't always take in the fish because you're concentrating on the camera, getting the angle right, getting the air off and everything else. So I'll probably use today to go and have a good look at the fish myself, without too much camera. Simply because in the past I've done the video and then I've gone home and thought, you know what, I didn't really sort of look at them fish, all I did was look at them through the camera. So I think I'll spend today, as I say, just admiring them myself. So Tony's going around systematically as a team, so it's not an individual thing, it's a team thing. And you can see the concentration on their faces looking at these fish. Yeah, it's very good. Well, it's about 10:30 now, Saturday morning. Had a cracking day yesterday at the show, and I basically went round without the camera. It was just nice to see all the fish and admire them for myself in my own time without having to worry about, filming them. So we're back here this morning. All the signs will be up as to what's won what. So I'll go around systematically as best I can and capture all the fish and no doubt be congratulating a number of people. So really looking forward to it. But right now, after a typical Japanese dinner last night, which I managed to avoid the sea urchin, I'm Hank Marvin, which is another word for starving. So priority before I do anything is get some grub down my neck. Yeah, I thought I'd start off actually having a look at, before we get to the real big prizes, there's some other prizes out here, but we'll have a look at a select few of those, but concentrate on the main fish. And in the past I've tried to video everything and it's a bit of a mess in truth, so I'm going to try and be a bit more selective in what I actually video during the course of today.
Can't think of anything. In white satin, never reaching the end. Letters I've written, never meaning to send. Beauty I'd always missed with these eyes before. Just what the truth is, I can't say anymore, 'cause I love you. Some try to tell me thoughts they cannot defend. Just what you want to be, you will be in the end. And I love you. Thank you.
We're looking for a person.
A guy with glasses, yeah.
Maybe Korean if we can get it, yeah?
Yeah.
To get some glasses to check whether it is a long lost relative.
Yeah.
Because so obviously got Korean blood in him. We just
been hit, he's been hitting me all week.
I'm taller than that, mate, you know. I've checked him out. He's 5'5" and a half.
Oh, is he?
Yeah, I'm 5'7".
He's probably wearing heels.
Pete, done really well.
Yes, very pleased.
This must be the best year you've done, is it?
Yes, yes.
Yeah, so you've flown in. Did you know last night how well you've done?
No, I came straight from the airport. I bumped into Gary Gatwick on the way. And I arrived and Simon had a big smile on his face and he said, do you know any of the results? And I said, no, I've got no idea. And he said to me, the Shiro won best in variety. And I said, oh, great, that's a relief, because I had a bet with Ryuki, because Ryuki had the previous winner from last year.
Yeah.
And he entered it this year, but he was winding me up saying that he hoped mine would win, and if it didn't win, he would take it next year and look after it and then enter it next year for me. But now it's won, it'll be shipped. So,
yeah, super.
So people will be able to see a nice...
But you've shown this fish before at the All Japan,
yes,
haven't you?
They won at 65 BU.
Right.
And then we had two quiet years where I don't think it was actually even placed. One year I don't think it was placed, and the other year we didn't enter it. And it's obviously bounced back brilliantly.
Yeah, it looks amazing. Yeah,
no, very pleased. But it just shows again, you know, how these fish do have periods, quiet periods when they're growing. I certainly, when I bought it at Sansai, I didn't think for one moment it'd be, you know, I'd be sitting here or standing here with an 83 centimetre
Shiro.
And
you've got a Kikuyu as well?
Yes, the Hoshkin,
yeah, so we'll
65.
Yeah, so I'll have a quick look at this then, Pete.
Okay.
And then if we can have a look at your others. You've got six fish here then?
Yes, and they've all done very well. They've either won or been placed.
Yeah, let's have a look at this.
Don't let Kevin or myself try and explain.
It's a big Shiro with great volume, Mike.
It's very photogenic.
Photogenic, it keeps coming up.
It's obviously
female.
Yeah. No,
look at the three of you there. It's like a scene out of Usual Suspects. I've seen the film. Reservoir Dogs.
I've seen Reservoir Dogs.
Thanks for that.
Yeah, no, look at that. It's amazing, yeah, it's shape. So it's like 83
it's
like cm.
Stock and rolling barrels.
Look at that.
Which bud line?
It's going to be Vinnie Jones.
Which bud line this one?
I can't remember.
Canon
I. I want to say Panda. It's definitely not Godzilla.
Lovely body.
How long have they been doing Panda Junior for?
Not long finished.
Yeah, that's what I don't think. I don't think it's Panda Junior. I think it might be Panda.
So this is Pete's other prize. This is Kikuyu with a Kahaku from Hoshkin. This one, Pete?
2 years, just over three years. It went into the Wagagoy last year, was placed in the Wagagoy. Obviously, the Wagagoy is 63 centimetres or below. So it was placed there, which was very good. And it's progressed, as I say, and it's just won best fish in all varieties in 65 BU, which
is a major prize.
Which is a major prize, obviously.
Yeah.
And it's great. We were kind of had a dilemma whether to enter it back in the Wagagoy, this time to go for the top award at 63, which meant we would have had to starve it. But Ryuki basically said, you're cool, but I said, no, just let the fish do its thing, and if it's too big for the Wagagoy, so be it.
So Wagagoy is up to 63?
63,
that must be close on the money.
It was dead on 63.
It is.
Yeah, and that's why he said we should either just stop feeding and leave it, put it in cold water, and I said, no, just let it be. So no, really pleased, because I was worried that we would be interfering with it. But I've always liked the cheeks as well as
it's a beautiful fish.
It's got the quality of this.
Yeah.
You know, it's coming on well.
Yeah, well done, Pete. That's superb, buddy. Yeah, well done.
So this one is the Kondo Kahaku. Not sure if this is second or third place, but it's either second or third place in 70 BU Kahaku. So very pleasing, really good quality fish, as you can see.
It is
Sashi
amazing
Kiwa
quality.
Classic three-step with a kind of keyhole type first
standard pattern. Challenge now is really to put some body on her, but the quality is clearly there. Very strong backbone, so the expectation is she will be a big fish. She's, I think, yeah, 4 years at 70. She's 4 years old. She's more or less on the money at 70. So we're
one to watch expecting. For the future.
Yeah.
She's got great shape to get big, Pete.
Yes, no, that's what we're. Definitely got a lovely body line, but say it's now a case of just putting some more body on if she's going to compete at the bigger sizes.
Yeah,
so,
cool. Yeah, we'll no, well done. Yeah.
It's the Goshki on the right of the two. Yeah. So it's the one on the right. Kano Goshki, the game got second or third. In the 55, this is the 55 BU. Goshki.
And that's from, where is it, Pete?
Kano. That one's from Kano, yeah. I've had it 2 years. Again, last year, it was placed in a smaller size. I think it was 45. So again, it seems to be a consistent performer. And now we've got to find the Ginrin.
We got
off.
A Ginrin Showa, was it?
No, Ginrin Kahaku,
right.
One.
Nemo, when you're watching this, here's your Shiro buddy. Cracking fish, well done.
Nemo, when you're watching this, this is the fish that beat your Shiro. Out of curiosity.
Yeah, Pete's got another fish, we couldn't find it, but yeah, inspiring and well done again, Pete, and you, Si. Yeah, great fish. And yeah, just shows you it can all come right. Spent a lot of money probably getting there, but yeah, that's the All Japan Koi Show for you. And yeah, great fish.
Oh, from Sakai many years. Yeah, Johannes has been one of the top customers at Sakai for many, many years. A real koi nut, this one. Loves koi, appreciates koi. Really knows what he's looking at as well, and has one of the best collections in the world. Including how many pieces you show here today? Sorry, I'm making you a little bit embarrassed.
You're being modest, I can tell.
Yeah, very modest, very modest, gentleman of note, this guy. Yeah.
No, just a hobbyist that really enjoy koi and start keeping it, start going to Osaka. I think I met Tony 2007, 2008.
Yeah, I think so, just after Japan.
Yeah. And haven't seen him for a while, and recently this year I met this guy again.
Yeah, he's been a playboy in South Africa. Well, he's having to work now.
It's always a pleasure to spend time with him. Spending time with him is always a pleasure.
As I have done for the week. So do you keep fish here in Japan with the breeders, obviously, for the shows?
Yes.
And
yes,
you keep fish back home?
Yes, I do.
Right. And what sort of ponds do you have back home? And what are the challenges of keeping koi?
I have a 60-ton pond, and I keep not too many koi, about 15. It's a challenge in my country back home because the weather is always hot, so it's a bit hard to maintain the benny, and a lot of pollution, so raining time, then the water condition can easily drop, and from the pH and the TDS, so it's a challenge.
But what do you strive to keep in terms of water parameters?
I use a reverse osmosis to maintain to fill in the water in my pond, and use a digital parameter just to make sure the pH level and the temperature, which is very important to koi. So other than that, if you have a good filtration system, koi is not hard to maintain.
And what sort of pH do you prefer?
7.6 around there.
Right. Yeah. And what would your TDS typically be?
In my pond, I keep mine. It depends actually. If you wanna, I play around with it sometimes. If you wanna finishing for the sumi, then I keep slightly higher to 180 or 160. But if I'm maintaining just the koi for every day, then I keep it around 120 to 100.
And if you wasn't running reverse osmosis, what sort of pH would you have?
Probably with the rain, acid, probably around 6.
Right, so too low.
Too low, yes. Right. And the groundwater that I got, the TDS was very, very high. It's about 300 to 400. So, yeah.
Yeah, so that is a challenge.
It is. Other than that, koi is a beautiful living thing, and it's not easy to maintain. They eat a lot. And as long as you got a good filtration, you control the ammonia, everything's...
And what that, filtration would you have then on a pond of that size?
About 30 ton, about 50%.
Right.
Chambers, biological, the old-fashioned way. I don't use those, the new one with...
Drums?
Drums, no, right. I don't use them.
Right, okay. Yeah, no, cool. Mm. No, thank you very much. It'll
You're
be
welcome.
Interesting for hobbyists back in
You're
the
welcome.
UK.
Well,
so
I hope...
You,
I hope. Yeah? I mean, the UK koi... Back around maybe 2007, 2006, it was a big thing. It was, many, many koi enter in all Japan. So I hope we'll be, more hobbyists from UK to come back and start keeping koi.
And that's what Tony's here for.
Yes, exactly.
And we have a friend of ours, Peter.
Contact Tony,
well.
He's the right man for the job.
There you go.
No problem.
How much are you paying for that? Yeah, no, that's very kind. Yeah. Thank you very much.
He wouldn't accept even if I offered.
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah,
no,
super.
That's our friendship offer.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Rising seem to beckon me.
Yeah, so I've just gone round the major prizes in one part of the hall, the bigger fish. When you go round, I could easily video every vat, it's too many. And you pass on some fish that are amazing fish. As you can see, I've tried to focus on the vats that have got that big plaque thing, yeah, which tends to, you know, make it the bigger prizes. But next door or either side, it's again some truly amazing fish, and it's probably a shame I'm not capturing them all, but just not realistic really. As I say, I've yet to do the main champions, but right now need to go and have some lunch. Well, much needed lunch, and yeah, before we go down to the bottom section, we'll have a look at the dream koi section, which are generally fish for sale, and yeah, some of these fish you end up seeing 2 or 3 years down the line. Some of them you probably never see the light of day again, but yeah, let's have a look.
Sing to you of northern lights, I sing for you of northern nights. Past the future, here or there, shelter comes in words from you, so talk to me. I hear your voice, it comforts me in morning dreams. Between the days, early hours pass away. Sing to you of northern lights, sing for you of northern nights. The northern lights are in my mind, they guide me back.
I will lay me down.
Do it just me and you and the
Some great fish here, and I'm doing my best to capture them all, and I keep going back looking at fish I'm not capturing and thinking to myself I should be, but it just seems there's so many fish. I don't know whether it'd get boring just getting fish after fish after fish. I don't know, I play it by ear, but right now, you know, still got a lot of fish to do, including, you know, the big major winners. So yeah, unbelievable. I saw these fish yesterday, close quarters, and I'm looking at them again through the camera. Then I have to put the camera down and just look at the fish. You know, spellbounding. Absolutely amazing.
Tears run down from my eyes.
The bigger fish now in the main section, but I'm now being a bit more selective in terms of not videoing everything because there's just too many. So I'm probably cutting out the non-go Sankey and Shiro's, getting the odd one in, but yeah, otherwise I'll be here forever and a day. Got some other filming to do, but trying to condense the video to the, you know, go Sankey if I can. That's that is the boys. So yeah, anyway.
Your heart. Look around you. Change your heart. It will astound you. I need your loving. Like the sunshine. And everybody's got a lump sometime. Everybody's got a lump sometime. Everybody's got a lump sometime. Mm-hmm.
Well, it's Sunday morning now, and yeah, today's the prize giving, which is a real nice celebration here. Really looking forward to it. And not least of all, we've got a couple of Brits going up for some awards, so that makes it even more interesting. But yeah, so let's capture that. Probably re-look at a couple of the fish that I missed yesterday, or probably didn't capture as well as I would have liked. And always a topic of conversation overnight about what's one what and one thing and another. But yeah, let's capture it, and really looking forward to it. Well, Tone, congratulations, buddy. Sakura Prize. I guess Sai's going up, getting it on your behalf and doing a speech like he would. So, yeah, congratulations, mate. Yeah, nice. I'm not sure what it is, what breed it is, not black and metallic, but you know what? Yeah, well done.
How are you doing?
All right, mate. So I just bumped into Darren. We caught up with you yesterday. Yeah, uh-huh. Darren from Absolute.
Yeah,
so, yeah, yesterday morning, your eyes were bloodshot. You looked knackered.
To be honest, straight. My flight was late from Humberside. So that was an hour and a half late. By the time we actually got to Schiphol, it was like running, to get a plane. So I was lucky my bags turned up as well this morning. Came straight from the airport, straight to the show with bags and everything. So, yeah.
So what's your movements and objectives now over the coming few days?
Well, catch up a little bit today, spend another half day at the show or so, and then we'll be getting trained down to Okayama. We're doing probably Sakai, Hiroshima tomorrow, Monday, and maybe Omasako, auction, open sale at Momotaro Tuesday, Wednesday's the auction on, so Thursday, maybe Matsue, that's got to be confirmed yet, so yeah, that should do us, then Friday I fly back, just a bit of a touchdown, grab the show, grab the auction, and then back, and then come back out later on, maybe April time for the Tosai. Yeah.
So your objective now is more sort of Nisai Sansai, is it?
Yeah, Nisai Sansai. We'll see where the auction goes. And there's going to be a lot of Asian, guys out there. So I suspect that there's a lot of great fish as well. So I suspect the price is going to be really high. But at the end of the day, we're so close to the show as well that it makes sense to do them both together. So
yeah,
we'll
and
see.
When will those fish come to the shop now?
They'll come to the shop probably, I guess, end of Feb.
Yeah, cool.
Something like that. I'd like to think that we get, half a dozen pieces, but, we'll see.
Yeah, we'll see. But equally, with them auctions, you've got to be in it to win it.
Some of the fish that's there's out of our niche market anyway, by a long way, and I dare say, 90% of koi dealers, a lot of them are going Asia way, but at the end of the day, like you say, you never know.
But equally, the fish you've been bringing back since I've known you last year and that, you managed to find some nice fish at the right sort of budget parameters for your market, as you say.
Yeah.
So they're out there.
I think the thing is, when you've got that many fish, 200 fish at the auction, it's human, it's natural for your eye to get in, and you start looking at the really top five, top ten.
Yeah.
When you actually start looking, there's some great fish, that's further down the list, and sometimes, you see fish for real that you didn't see on the videos or, on the pictures, so...
Well, I look forward to following you on Facebook then.
All right, cheers.
And me, like all the other obvious, we want these all Japan winning fish for about £1,000,
so that's
a challenge now.
Okay, right. I'll see what we can do.
Yeah.
All right, cheers, Kev.
の品評会が皆様方の育ててこられた錦鯉のですね品評会として世界最大の第75部変わり鯉。
賞状国技賞第65部紅白ピーター・ルイス殿おめでとうございますコングラチュレーション
What's happening now, just thought I'd capture a few fish going in the bags, especially the sakeye ones, obviously back to their home where they come from. So if I can get the fish in the bag, just showing the size of these things as they come out, it's incredible, especially the GC if I'm lucky. Crikey, this is one slick operation here, getting these fish out. Honestly, they are running left, right and centre. Leaving the big fish till last, and hopefully I don't know whether it'll be up the Dainichi end or the Momotaro end or the Sakai end, because I want to get them real big ones. But yeah, really busy here right now. So Monday morning now, and heading back to London, heading back to home, heading back to work for a rest. So yeah, thanks all guys for watching. Do a synopsis when I get home, and yeah, it's been fun, really has. Educational as well, and Tony and Sire, couldn't have wished for two better people to be in Japan with. So yeah, let's get on that plane, get home.
Dress.
got back yesterday, jet lag like you can't believe, but you know what? What a magnificent trip that turned out to be. Really was a great trip. And thanks to Tony and Sio and everyone that we met up with, it was, you know, one to remember, that's for sure. And, you know, there's lots of highlights, but looking back on the video briefly as I did this morning, I hope I've gone some way to capturing it. You know, and not least of all, going, as a, you know, someone just asked me about the smaller breeders. You know, you go to somewhere like Beppu, which is tiny by comparison to Omosako and Sakai and so forth. But you know what? They too have got some magnificent fish, just not as many of them. You know, it's like an economy of scale. But, you know, all said and done, it was a great trip. And, you know, acquired some nice fish. I look forward to seeing them at the end of February, March, when they come into the barn. Always an exciting time at Koi Water Barn. And Tony, got to congratulate you on, you know, your eye. You know, you certainly picked, not just for me, but for some others, you know, some great fish to pick from. And not least of all, you found me a kajaku. I genuinely have been looking for a kajaku for like 6 years. You found it within half an hour, and thanks to your tenacity, and Saya probably flashing her eyes, we managed to secure that fish. So, you know, really pleased with that too. So guys, yeah, trip's at an end. You know, all Japan, cracking, you know, couple of days. And for me, that's the, you know, the harvest time is end of October, early November. A lot of people go then. For me, one trip a year, which is all I ever plan on doing, that end of January, taking in the All Japan show, is the time of year I prefer to go. And there's still a lot of fish, certainly at my budget parameter, to choose from at these breeders. It's not like they all get sold in October and November. And to be able to take in the All Japan, and not least of all, I come back to my pond yesterday afternoon, went straight down the pond before I even said hello to the missus. I then realise how tiny my fish are, because, you know, Sakai, Momotaro with Showa especially, are taking them to a whole new level. You know, we were seeing fish from, you know, 100 centimetres up to 110 centimetres, but lots of them. That's the thing. The 91 metre fish, there was no shortage of them at Momotaro. And, you know, we saw some at the show as well. So, you know, I can't help thinking the All Japan won't get one again, Grand Champion, with an 85 centimetre Showa like it did 3 years ago. As great as that fish was, Showa have now taken over, in my opinion, as the biggest of the Gosanki, as opposed to the smallest, thanks to Momotaro. But anyway, as I say, that brings the trip to a conclusion. And again, Sio, Tony, you are great company. And yeah, look forward to catching up with you guys again. Now I better get on with editing this, because people are badgering me already to see it. So yeah, thanks all you guys for watching. Thanks for all the comments I've had through Facebook and so forth. And yeah, look forward to seeing the fish down at the barn in 4, 5, 6 weeks.
One, two, three, go.